And welcome back to Let's Play Torment, Tides of Numenera. Make sure you can hear me. My headset's been weird lately. Sometimes I can hear myself, sometimes I can't.
All right.
That's not all right. Anyway, we're going to some one of these other locations in the necropolis here, but we've been to all these except for the Endless Gate, which I want to go to next, and the first castoff's tomb, which I is supposed to go to Meal Avest. Let's try some random thing. Not anything special. Look at that. I guess it's the one that makes it. I don't like how they're all like not lined up. One isn't, because one is narrower. Let's try 1, 2, 3, 4. Pulling at my gut. Oh, look at that. So these are just going to be names, I guess. Cyan, Amambanev, or whatever. Xanthus? Almost sounds like Xathrus. Oh, not the one. Not the one.
Going.
You're trying to go. Eric Christensen. These are just probably backers of the game. I don't think I pledged enough to get my name into it, so what's this?
On it.
One of those plaques. Sadly, his ascension to lichdom didn't go so well. Anton Kane. I guess the plaques are people who put in more money to a certain tier or level or something.
I'm ready.
So I notice there's no zero. So we went to the first one. What would be the first one anyway? 1, 1, 1, 1. I'm assuming 5, 5, 5, 5 would be the last one. Well, so you also have an option to go to a random tomb. Look at these things.
I'm ready.
No plaque here?
Ready.
They ran out of plaques.
Let's go.
I guess there wasn't 5,555 people who, you know, contributed or donated to a certain tier.
Of course.
So at some point the plaques run out, I'm supposing? Just a guess. Press randomly. In no particular order. Oh. Hello? Oh, Silver. Again, you meet the strange humanoid calling itself Silver. It seems different, though. Upset. More tombs. More tantalum. More searching. Frustration boils under its calm tones. Must search. Must know. It turns and methodically bangs its head into the wall of the tomb. Must. Must. And he thinks, so close. Not close at all. Must find more. Oh, this has been strange, but farewell. I thought he was going to look for tantalum next. Are you alright, Silver? Silver. A seeker. A curse. A question seeking an answer. Driven to find it. Are you saying you're under some kind of curse? Trouble. Air. Dust. Knowledge. Despair. Silver jerks and twitches. Epiphanies do not reveal themselves. No moments of inspiration. A single oily droplet oozes from its forehead. But I must continue. What are you talking about? A man. A man torn in time and knowledge. A man? Yes. Not a construct. Not a shell. A mind. in a shell. Did Tantalum do something to you? No. Tantalum. He is the sender, the giver, the mortal who knows secrets. He sends quests. Silver seems disoriented, jerking about as if someone controlled his movements. He thinks, he set me on this course. I have no choice. I must follow it to its end. Silver holds up his hand. No. Stop. Questions. Too much. Compulsion rises. Must find new. Tomb. He clutches his hands to his head. Trapped in numbers. Trapped in prime form. Rolling through differentials. Imaginary in substance. Must find tomb. He stops and draws himself together. His voice has changed, becoming flat and emotionless. I must go. How can I help? I do not require aid. Oh, my gold tide ride. Oh, my tide's changed. I forgot to look at it. Does it say? No. Silver pushes you aside and marches away. Alright, let's check out my tides. My dominant tide is gold. As someone who's sad. Get who it was. A very, I don't know, one of my favorite commenters. The name's on the tip of my tongue. I know the name, it's just on the tip of my tongue, you know, when you know something and it's not coming out. The Ordarian, I believe? Not completely sure. I was talking about how I am of gold. I should be all complete gold, and now I am. Although I have blue coming in now and then, depending on what I do, because I also have, you know, an unquenchable thirst for knowledge, so sometimes that comes into play. But for now, we're gold. It's the old goldy. Compassion and that kind of thing. Alright, I don't see any monument here, so...
Of course.
We're at 1222. Huh. If I go to random ones, is it gonna give me, a special thing every time? So find out. Yes or no, about pressing tab? Well, nothing here. There's plaques. Have I been here? Cattle will die. Friends will die. You will die as well. But one thing will live forever. Your reputation. I don't think even that's gonna last. Delnarin crank toggle. Sounds like a gnome.
I'm ready.
I should have made dexterity a priority. Timothy Donuts. Right.
Why not?
Alright, we're going to try one more random one. See if we run into silver again. And then I'm heading... 1, 2, 3, 3 we're at. They should tell us when we get here which one we're at instead of, you know, finding out after. Randomly. So next, I'm assuming we're going to go to the Endless Gate. Ooh, they're all like oily and stuff.
Go.
The epitaph has been worn down by the passage of time. Nothing remains but a name. Michael Beard.
Yes.
What? Michael's beard? Where's the rest of them? Okay, let's go to... I wonder if it gives me these. Now, see, it doesn't give you... You can't randomly go back to one of the random ones. Now, I guess if you, you know... These are obviously Kickstarter backers. So I'm wondering if you... I guess when you had your name put into the game, they'll tell you, yeah, go to this code. This is the code to see where your name is. I'm assuming. Otherwise, you have to look through how many permutations... 5 squared. which is not even... Sorry, guys. Yeah, I'm not good with math, so obviously 1111, 1112, all the way up to 5554, 5555. Alright, so quite a lot. Hundreds. Let us, yeah, when are we ready now? The Endless Gate. Da da da. Same text as always. Oh, hello, children. More souls to release. The gate, it calls. It's time, and gibbers unintelligibly. You can see the whites all around this man's eyes. His face is frozen in a rictus of frenzy. Can you feel it? The power of the Endless Gate. It calls to us. It's time. Time for what? Power. Glory. Ecstasy. He stares at something behind your head. You're not sure whether he actually heard you at all. Before he can utter another word, the man's spine goes taut. His expression becomes that of a towel being savagely wrung out. What kind of expression? I'm trying to picture that. But his voice stays drenched in childish glee. Now I'm really trying to picture what that voice looks like. Or that face looks like. His expression. They call us now! So this must be the gate we've been talking about. Can I zoom in? Join us! Shrieks. The masters beckon. For glory! We hear and obey. Okay. Alrighty then. I'm not leaving. We can examine. Most of these pods can be opened on one side. Several contain humans, many of them Sega citizens by their clothing. Yeah, I guess they look small, but then again they're not too much bigger than we are. So, and we have this. Where the blood does not obscure it, vaguely humanoid shadows lie within these pods. Oh, so these are pods too. I guess these stand and these lay down. We can interact with that. We can't look at this body, I guess.
I'm going.
So I guess we can open one pod. Why is this written as if someone says it? An obscene quantity of blood adorns the floor and walls of this tomb. Messages in a bastardized form of the truth are traced on the bloody walls. The cultists who have overrun the valley seem to have a special affinity for the occupant of this pod. But try as you might, you can't find anything useful here, and you back away with no fresh insight. It's almost like this was written on the pod, but yet this is highlighted and this is not. So I see an error on their part. Try to read the name. You cannot read the name, for it is obscured by splatters of blood smeared by the venerating touch of countless passing cultists. Can we wipe the blood off or something? Same. There's a special thing. If you try to read the name 77 times, you finally get it. Nah, I'm not in the patience for that. Just kidding, guys. Okay, I guess we're going into the Endless Gate. I have no idea why we would do such a thing. Teleport terminal. It doesn't appear as in like an exit from the zone.
Go.
Cloying invisible fingers tug at your skin. They're drawing you into the portal, eager for the life that flows through your body, eager to keep you here. You have a bad feeling that, once you step through this gate, there will be no way out except to find the one who opened it. So how are we with stats and stuff? We're actually pretty decent. Right, because we rested. My intellect's down 4, as I tried to persuade somebody of something, I think. Everyone else is at full. Well, Eretus is missing some XP. Tiber a tiny bit. Oh god, Calistige! Really? Oh no, her XP. Never mind. I'm trying to look at her health. Which... I got that confused with health. Okay, 33. Duh. Duh, guys. And I'm saying XP too, and I'm just... I'm tired. Alright, we're going in. I saved right before we, you know, before this episode, so...
I'll remember that.
You better remember that. Excited. Oh, there's that symbol. We're gonna run into Casca? The cloying fingers release you, perhaps knowing there is nowhere for you to go. You're within the endless gate now. You are theirs. I don't want to be theirs. The air is chill and moist. Screams of agony permeate the darkness around you, and you sense something watching. There's no choice but to venture forth. Must gather our party before venturing. I see that thing. What the hell is that? The endless gate, indeed. Are there more things over there?
Action! Here I come!
Yeah. I don't know if you're up for this action. Looks like a cross between a starship and a gelatinous cube? Black pudding or something?
Yes.
Several people have been flayed, their skins stretched into grotesque banners. Oh my god, that's skin? People? Faces contorted in a rictus of eternal pain. The skins flap back and forth in a wind you do not feel. Beyond them you see a clear passage deeper into this hell. Suddenly, a pair of eyes snaps open. These are not flayed skins, but living people. Kill us, it rasps. The children brought us here, not to die, but to suffer. To feed the things that live here. Slowly. Eternally. Well, how did the children get past the thing, the whisper, whatever. The whisper lock? Whisper lock, I believe it is called, yeah. How did they get past that? Was the whisper lock formed after they went through? Or did we open it and then they could just run through when they beat us here? No! The skin behind the first, partially obscured in a dark mist, shakes herself awake. Her face remains twisted in agony, even as she speaks. Our deaths make them stronger. If you kill us, you will only die here as well. Run. Save yourself. There is only death. A third voice moans from the darkness beyond the first two. Its eyes remain closed, its mouth gnarled in an ugly grimace. Kill us, or the children, or both, or neither. It does not matter. Death is all that awaits you. The three skins squeeze their eyes shut, their mouths open in wordless screams as some new agony befalls them. A malevolent presence weighs down upon you. Something watches with eager anticipation. It almost wants you to kill them. Almost? Well, I knew someone was watching us already. Should we kill them? That's a foot. That is a foot. Good God. This is like something out of a Clive Barker novel. Leave them alone. I mean, maybe there's some other way to help them? What's the crueler option?
All right.
Of course.
Oh. Gate cultists. They're like, possessed or something. Greetings. How did I know? There's a whole bunch. Oh, they're already partially damaged. Which is good, because these cultists we saw a couple episodes ago actually hit hard. I'm assuming that bar is their hit points? Sucker punch. Take him down. Finish him off. Mm-hmm. One down. Oh, we got the hook. Uh-oh. Well, you want an action, Eretus. Oh my. They're all hitting him. He seriously needs a heal. He is down 16 out of 41. Whose turn is it? It's my turn, good. I hate to use these 16 ones. But that would give him 32, yeah. I think I have two of these. You like that, huh? She's quite far away. I don't know if I should debuff or just kill them with pure force as much as possible. Transdimensional damage, and then hobbled. Oh wait, I thought there was an area effect? Wait, is it? Enemies in small cone? Wait. Yeah, we can't use that. Transdimensional is one enemy. Yeah. Yeah, I don't have anything good. I want it like an area effect, but she doesn't have anything like that, does she? Flash, maybe? Oh, enemies in immediate area? Yeah, that can hit all them. If I try to hit this one, I get Eretus. So let's not do that. Well, they're out of range. Still out of range. Here we go.
Come, taste your death.
Haha. Now have her run up too.
It is done.
Oh, what's that? It inhaled them. What? Oh, good God, there's blood all over the place. It doesn't show up. Oh, that's messed up. Okay. It seemed to miss everyone, except there's blood all over the place. Okay, whose turn is it? Flex skill. Yeah, I think we're gonna... Yeah, I'll just have him attack. I don't want to sucker punch every time. He might just kill him this time. Basic attack. Yep. One down. Eretus. Oh, we got this. Oh wait. No, I mean this. The arc. Fell swoop. Damage to all who fail to evade. I guess he evaded. Oh. Oh, you're pissed at him, aren't you? Oh, he brought... Oh, he pulled her in. I didn't realize that was Calisteve. My turn. See, I could just hit him. But I think... one of these will do even better. Eh, flash, yeah. I don't want to click that. It got in the way. Wait. Get that out of the way. There we go. Ah, man. A waste. Okay. Kill this guy. And get away from these teeth things.
Another one dispatched.
Okay. Run over here. It's in healing. Ugh. Oh. Not good. Lurker's presence converts all damage to mental and negative one resistance plus 15% on attacks minus plus 3 damage. That's a fettle? Yeah, I guess it's... Alright, well... whose turn is it? Tiber? Let's do the sucker punch again. Jeez, Calisteus is banged up. Real good here.
Yes.
Actually, wait. Spray flesh. We have 3. Okay, so those we will use outside of combat.
Here. Now.
Okay. Oh, wait.
Shall we?
So it gave her 13 back. It says 8, too. Hmm. Alright. Should I... Let's see what we pick up. Because I only have 2 left.
Yes.
I'd give one to Tiber. So we got 14 shins and a dagger here.
On it.
Here's a spray flash. Okay. And then a dagger, 11 shins. What about... enough for these? Alright, I'm gonna heal him with that. We gotta buy more of these things, these spray flash things. Can I... wait, I can use it, right? Choose an ally. Okay, cool. He is completely full. And she's 27 out of 33, which is good enough. 37 out of 41 for Eretus, and I'm full of health. Okay. I feel like saving now. Planescape 64. Sounds like it could go on, you know, Nintendo 64 console. I just have a habit of looking to make sure the save is there. Just a habit. Okay, so what did this journal say? The cult's leader, Inifir, is somewhere beyond the Endless Gate itself. There's no way for me to leave now that I'm here. I need to find Inifir and convince him to close the gate, or else force him to. I found the Endless Gate's entrance in the necropolis. Several cultists were sucked into it, shrieking, "It's time!" I don't know what that means, but I'm pretty sure the only way to close the gate is to follow them in there. Okay. Alright, continuing. There's one of those, flesh flapping skin beings. Fine. These skins are like the others you met, alive and in eternal pain. One of them snaps its eyes open as you approach. "Kill us! You will reach the center more quickly." "No," a second moans behind him. "When we die, they go stronger. You will never survive." Huh. Well, which one's telling the truth? I'm gonna leave them.
Action. Here I come.
Maybe there's some other way to save them? I kinda doubt it. But you never know. More fight. We've got six now.
Sure enough.
Combat, baby. You guys wanted combat, I'm sure. Here we go. Yep, no words exchanged. Just time to attack.